Voglio parlare di mettere la radio, vorrei mettere un buon sole. Che...
Hello, shall we start?
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
So we will continue from where we left in the last class. So we were actually discussing these zero divisors, important elements and units. So, we will discuss first what do we mean by a primer, this principal idea. Okay. So, principal idea. Principal ideal. So an ideal P in A is said to be a principal ideal if it is generated by a single element that is to say that for some X in A equals AX or it is equal to XA and it is the set, it is of this form AX such that A is in A. Okay, so this is what we mean by a principal ideal. And an integral domain A is said to be a principal ideal domain or in short it is PID if every ideal of A is a principal ideal. Is a principal ideal. So, well-known examples of principal ideal domains, you know these examples. We have already studied it. This Z is a principal ideal domain. Fx, where F is a field, is a field. Is they all are principal ideal domains, are principal ideal domains. Okay. Now, one of the well-known facts that we will use maybe later on is this one. So this is a small fact. It says that X belonging to A is a unit if and only if the principal ideal generated by this is whole of A. X belonging to A is a unit if and only if the principal ideal generated by X is आप म्यूट करो. हेलो, क्या आवाज आ रही है बैकग्राउंड से? प्लीज म्यूट इट. सो प्रूफ ऑफ दिस, सो सपोज X इज ए यूनिट. सपोज X इज ए unit. Unit means what? Means there exists some Y in A such that X, Y is one. Now, this is an ideal. So, this is a subset of A. So AX is clearly a subset of A. It is clear. Now, conversely, we show that A is a subset of this. A is a subset of X. So, if say you have Z belonging to A, then you can write Z as Z into 1, and which is Z, one is this XY, okay, Z XY, and the ring is commutative, so it is Z Y X, okay. So it belongs to AX, So thus you have A is contained in AX. So A is same as AX. So X is a unit if implies A is same as AX. Conversely, if you have A is same as AX, means what? It implies that AX के बराबर है. इसका मतलब क्या हुआ? For all Z in A, Z equal to YX for some Y in A. है ना, इस इक्वेशन का सोल्यूशन होगा आपके पास. हर किसी जेड को आप ऐसे लिख सकते हैं जेड इक्वल्स वाई एक्स और सम वाई इन ए। इन पर्टिकुलर वन भी तो ए का मेंबर है, तो वन के लिए भी इस इक्वेशन का सोल्यूशन। इन पर्टिकुलर वन इक्वल टू वाई एक्स फॉर सम वाई इन ए, एंड व्हाट डज इट मीन, इट मीन्स वाई इज द इनवर्स ऑफ एक्स, सो दस एक्स इज ए यूनिट, दस एक्स इज ए यूनिट इन ए। सो वी हैव प्रूवन दैट x belonging to A is a unit if and only if the principal ideal generated by this x is whole of A. Now we will use this fact in order to get a well-known theorem about homomorphisms and fields. This is a proposition. Non-zero ring, let A be a non-zero ring. The following are equivalent. The following are equivalent. First, A is a field. A are zero and A itself. We can say that fields have no proper ideals. The only ideals of A are zero and A. And third, every homomorphism. Every homomorphism A onto a non-zero ring, onto a non-zero ring is injective. ठीक है, तो होमोमॉर्फिज्म ए से किसी दूसरे नॉन जीरो रिंग पे हमेशा क्या होगी, इंजेक्टिव। अगर ऑन टू होगी तो इट मस्ट बी इंजेक्टिव। सो व्हाट डज इट मीन दैट दीज स्टेटमेंट्स आर इक्विवेलेंट? यस प्लीज आंसर।
First implies second, second implies third, and third first.
Yes. So we will see the equivalence of these statements. So each should imply the other. So first implies second. A is a field. So we have to show that every ideal of A is either zero or A itself. So let A be a field, and suppose now you take a non-zero ideal and show that it is A. Suppose so zero not equal to I, so I is a non-zero ideal in A. Non-zero, so it has to have at least one non-zero member.
So, बीच में आवाज ही नहीं आ रही है।
आवाज नहीं आ रही है।
So, बीच में।
So, wait for a while. एक मिनट का वेट करो।
close the ibara. Hello, now the voice is clear. Hello.
Yes sir.
So I is a non-zero ideal of A. So then A belonging to I for some non-zero A. Now this is a field. A is a field. So in field every non-zero is a unit, okay? So A is a unit. So A is a unit, and thus I contains this AA because it's an ideal, but by previous fact AA must be same as A. So this means I is same as A. So the only non-zero ideals of the only ideals of A are 0 and A, which is 2, which is the statement 2. So first implies 2. Now 2 implies 3. 2 implies 3. Now suppose the only ideals of A are 0 and A, and let F from A to B be an onto homomorphism. We must show that it is injective. Okay. So we will use this fact. F from, this is a well-known fact about homomorphism, zinc homomorphism. F from A to B is injective if and only if kernel of F is trivial. Kernel of F is 0. Okay. So this is a homomorphism. Now certainly kernel of F is different from A. Certainly kernel of F is not equal to A, whole of A. Why? Can anybody tell me? Yes. Kernel of F kyun nahi hoga A ke barabar?
Kyunki ye homomorphism hai to injective hoga.
No.
It is an onto homomorphism.
Eh? Shabash, good. Ye kisne bataya ye onto? Kisne bataya?
Me.
Haan, kya naam hai aap? Tumhara naam kya hai?
Rukaiya.
Haan, good, good. Shabash. Ye onto hai na? ये ऑन टू है. अगर ये अगर कर्नल ऑफ एफ ए हो जाएगा तो इसका मतलब हर कोई ए जो है वो जीरो को मैप होगा, फॉर ऑल ए इन ए, है ना? तो वो तो पॉसिबल नहीं है. ये तो कांस्टेंट मैप हो जाएगा फिर, है ना? सो इट वुड कंट्राडिक्ट द ऑन टूनेस. दिस इज बिकॉज एफ इज ऑन टू. But kernel of F is an ideal in A. But we are saying that the only ideals of A are 0 and A. So thus kernel of F must be 0. Thus kernel of F must be 0. And by this fact, F is injective. This means F is इंजेक्टिव. सो टू इंप्लाइज थ्री. नाउ थ्री इंप्लाइज वन. थ्री इंप्लाइज वन. थ्री इंप्लाइज वन. सपोज दैट थ्री होल्ड्स. सपोज दैट थ्री होल्ड्स एंड लेट एक्स बिलोंग्स टू ए. सो वी हैव टू शो दैट ए इज अ फील्ड. सो एवरी नॉन जीरो एलिमेंट मस्ट बी अ यूनिट. सो वी गो बाई contradiction. We suppose that x is not a unit. Let x belonging to A and x is not a unit and x is not a unit. We will show that it is zero. So once x is not a unit, again by previous fact this ideal AX is not equal to X. AX is not equal to A. Okay. So this means if you take the quotient ring A over AX is a non-zero ring. Is a non-zero ring. इसमें AX से ज़्यादा coset होंगे, ठीक है? क्योंकि ये आपका AX not equal to X है. क्वेश्चन रिंग जीरो कब होता है? अगर आप जिससे आप फैक्टर कर रहे हैं वो आइडियल सेम हो जाए ए के बराबर, है ना? ये फैक्ट भी आप याद रखना. ए ओवर आई इज जीरो इफ एंड ओनली इफ ए इज सेम एज आई. सो दिस इज ए नॉन जीरो रिंग. सो बाय थर्ड एवरी on to homomorphism from A to any other ring is injective. So in particular the natural map would also be injective. So by 3 the natural map, say phi from A to A over AX is injective. Is injective. Okay. Once it is injective, its kernel is trivial. So, its kernel is trivial. Now, what is the kernel of this natural map?
AX
is the kernel of this map. So, that is to say that AX is zero. AX is zero means what? It means that AX is zero for all A in A. In particular, you can take A equal to 1. If A is 1, then 1X, which is X, which is zero. Okay. So if X is not a unit, then X is zero. So this means what? This means if X is non-zero, then X must be a unit. Then X must be a unit. So this means what? This means A is a field, which is the statement one, which is one. So all the statements are equivalent. Okay. All the statements are equal. So fields are important rings in the sense that if you have any homomorphism between two fields is either zero or injective. Or in other words, they are important in the sense that they have these properties. This property. That every homomorphism of A, if it is onto a non-zero ring, देन इट मस्ट बी इंजेक्टिव. Now we will discuss some of the important types of ideals. They are actually called as prime and maximal ideals. Prime and maximal ideals. So an ideal P of A is called prime, is called prime if P is not the whole of A, P is different from A, and for all X and Y in A, the product XY in P implies X in P or Y in P. Okay, so this is the meaning of a prime ideal. First, it should be a proper ideal, in fact not equal to A, and if you have any pair of elements X and Y in A such that their product is in P, then one must be in P, one of them must be in P, at least one of them must be in P. Okay. And there is a small observation, you might be knowing it. So, if P is a non-zero ideal of A, then P is prime, then P is prime. If and only if the quotient ring A over P is an integral domain, is an integral. You know this or not? Yes. So proof of this is straightforward. Suppose P is prime. P is prime. Okay. So we must show that this is an integral domain, means it has no non-zero zero divisors. Let P plus X be a zero divisor. Be a zero divisor in A over P. Let it be a zero divisor in A over P. That means what? That means there exists P plus Y not equal to P in A over P such that P plus X multiply product P plus Y is what?
Is the that is
is P. This is the zero of this thing, right? Zero, zero of A is A by P is P. So this means that P plus XY is P. And this means that XY belongs to P. Okay. Now see here, you have P plus Y not equal to P. What does it imply? It implies that Y does not belong to P. Okay. Now XY belongs to P and Y does not belong to P. And P is prime.
X belongs to P.
Since P is prime, so X belongs to P. X belongs to P would imply that P plus X is P. P plus X is P. So what does it mean? पी प्लस एक्स इज पी मीन्स इट इज ए जीरो. सो दिस मीन्स दिस पी प्लस एक्स इज एक्चुअली जीरो ऑफ दिस रिंग ए बाई पी, जीरो ऑफ ए बाई पी. सो देयरफॉर ए बाई पी हैज नो नॉन जीरो जीरो डिवाइडर्स. सो दस ए बाई पी हैज नो नॉन जीरो जीरो डिवाइडर्स. So it is an integral domain. An integral domain. Now converse is straightforward. I will leave the converse as an exercise for you. It is just the reverse steps of these. If you go back these reverse steps, you would get that P is a prime ideal. So converse I will leave as an exercise. And as a corollary of this observation, you have this result. If A is a non-zero ring, then this zero is a prime ideal of A. Zero is a prime ideal of A if and only if A is an integral domain. A is an integral domain. You just take P equal to zero in this observation. You get that. Okay, you take P equal to zero, you will get this one. So it follows, proof follows by taking P is equal to zero in the previous observation. So follows by taking P equal to zero in the previous observation. Okay, so this is a well-known criteria for a ring to be an integral domain. You just need to show that zero is the prime ideal. Now, well-known integral domain is the ring of integers. So, what are the prime ideals of this Z? So the prime ideals of Z, the prime ideals of Z are 0 because it's an integral domain and PZ, where P is a prime number, where P is a प्राइम नंबर. देखो जेड के प्राइम आइडियल्स अगर आप लोगे या तो वो जीरो होगा या अगर नॉन जीरो होगा तो वो पी जेड फॉर्म का होगा वेयर पी इज ए प्राइम नंबर. और इसको आप स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड है तो जीरो तो होगा ही इसका प्राइम आइडियल क्योंकि ये इंटीग्रल डोमेन है. इस कॉरोलरी से आपको मिलेगा जीरो इज ए प्राइम आइडियल. ओके सो क्लियरली इफ यू वॉन्ट टू राइट द प्रूफ ऑफ दिस इसको आप एग्जाम्पल नहीं बल्कि इसको आप एक फैक्ट मान सकते हैं. ठीक है सो बाई प्रीवियस कॉरोलरी जीरो इज ए प्राइम आइडियल. ओके जीरो इज ए प्राइम आइडियल. ठीक है अब आपको दिखाना है पी जेड वेयर पी इज ए प्राइम नंबर इज ए प्राइम आइडियल. सो लेट से एक्स वाई बिलोंग टू पी जेड ओके लेट एक्स वेयर एक्स वाई आर इंटीजर्स एक्स एक्स एंड वाई दे आर इन जेड सो लेट एक्स वाई बिलोंग टू पी जेड सो व्हाट डज इट मीन
इट मीन इधर एक्स बिलोंग्स टू
तो एक्स वाई किस फॉर्म का होगा पी के फॉर सम के है ना फॉर सम के इन जेड सो इससे आपको क्या मिलेगा पी डिवाइड्स एक्स वाई बट पी इज ए प्राइम बट पी इज ए प्राइम सो पी इधर डिवाइड्स एक्स और डिवाइड्स वाई सो पी डिवाइड्स एक्स और पी डिवाइड्स वाई सो दिस मीन्स एक्स इज इक्वल टू से पी क्यू और y इक्वल टू p से s ठीक है फॉर सम q एंड s दे आर इन z सो व्हाट डज इट मीन इट मीन्स दैट x बिलोंग्स टू pz और y बिलोंग्स टू pz सो व्हाट डज इट मीन It means that PZ is a prime ideal. PZ is a prime ideal. Now, conversely, you have to show that ये statement जो है इसमें precisely आपको show करना है एक तरफ से तो आपने दिखा दिया कि PZ where P is a prime number is a prime ideal. Conversely, any prime ideal should be Conversely, any prime ideal should be either 0 or PZ, where P is a prime number. तो converse भी आपको इसका देखना है तो कोई नॉन जीरो आइडियल आप ले लो conversely, 0 के लिए तो आपके पास है ना If I not equal to 0, be an ideal of Z. तो z अभी हमने देखा जेड पी आई डी है हमने पीछे अभी किया जेड पी आई डी है तो i होगा फिर कोई प्रिंसिपल आइडियल होगा है ना i वुड बी सम एम जेड फॉर सम एम ग्रेटर देन वन बिलोंगिंग टू n क्योंकि ये हम अब प्रॉपर आइडियल ले रहे हैं इसलिए हम m को बड़ा लेंगे वन से This is because Z is principal ideal domain. ये तो आपको पता है ना कि Z PID होता है कि नहीं पता भाई अगर नहीं पता तो इसको देख लें Z PID होता है ठीक है